So inside of my Facebook group, Build Math Minds, there are a lot, and I mean a lot, of posts all about asking opinions around a certain curriculum or textbook. Basically, like wanting to find out, is this a good curriculum? Is this a good textbook series? I'm Christina Tonneville, the recovering traditionalist, and so today I wanted to spend a few moments talking about what is the best math curriculum that's out there. I hope you'll join me as we try to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, I'm going to start off with the answer you probably do not want to hear. There is no best math curriculum. Yes, I'm saying it. There are definitely ones that I personally like more than others, but my teaching style is different than your teaching style. And I know that this makes it super difficult when you have a school of lots of teachers, all with different philosophies about math education and teaching styles. Because even if you all have the same philosophy about how math should be taught, our style of teaching is different. And curriculums or textbook series, I'm going to go back and forth between both of those just because they go, I don't know, to me, they are the same thing. You can tell me in the comments how and if they should be different. But curriculum, textbook series, you'll hear me say both. So I'm going to tell you straight off, there will be no best curriculum. There's probably one that you will like more than another. But there's no way that your district is going to adopt a curriculum that makes everybody happy. Okay? It's just not going to be possible. So I want to talk about two things in particular that I personally like to look at when I'm helping districts evaluate curriculum. The first one is looking to see if there's more of an emphasis on conceptual understanding or procedural understanding. Now, here's the deal. If you've seen my previous videos, and probably pretty much any of them, I talk about we really need a balance of both. There are different philosophies in math education about we should teach procedural first and then bring in the conceptual. Other people believe we should do conceptual first and then practice the procedural afterwards. And there are still some who say, no, the emphasis should be on procedural. And there are others who say the emphasis should be on conceptual, not so much the procedural. So there are textbook series that adopt any, that go any of those ways. So I want you to be mindful of when you get a series, look to see how they are balancing conceptual and procedural. And I can pretty much guarantee you there isn't one that has a wonderful balance of both. You will find curriculums that tend to be more conceptual and they don't have as much practice and procedural skill-based stuff in them. You'll find a camp that is more procedural with little to no conceptual building, right? So it's not to say that any, like, as you've heard before, I want some of both, but textbooks don't necessarily have the best balance of those. So whatever it is that gets adopted, if you're part of that adoption, that's a piece I would want to be looking at. If you get a textbook after it's already been adopted, that's what I want you to look at. Where is this textbook having most of its emphasis? If it has a really strong emphasis on conceptual building, then you've got to be able to bring in the procedural stuff. Vice versa, if it's more procedural, I want you to be finding some conceptual building activities to supplement that curriculum. And I know it's hard because curriculums are set out, like there's already too much in the textbook to do in a year. But there are pieces where you have to say, like in previous videos, these are the most important pieces that my kids need to learn this year, and this textbook is really just focusing on procedural skills. So I've got to bring in some conceptual stuff around that. You don't have to bring in conceptual around everything, but you really want to make sure the foundational pieces of the big things need to be there, right? Okay, so conceptual versus procedural. You are going to be hard-pressed to find anything that is a nice balance of both. So just be aware and look for it and know what needs to be supplemented. The next piece is the curriculum more of a spiral-based or a mastery-based? Now, I will tell you there are there's research that you can find to back up both of those things. So I cannot say that one is better than another. I personally liked teaching out of a mastery-based curriculum more than I liked teaching out of a spiral-based curriculum. So here's the difference between the two. Again, this is a brief difference. You could probably have someone talk for a whole lot longer about the differences, but basically a spiral curriculum is where we introduce a topic and we don't go really in depth. So we introduce and then we work on a little bit and then we move on to another thing. And then we move on to another thing. We move on to another thing. But we'll spiral back around to that first thing we introduced to bring it back up. The theory behind this is that when we first introduce something, not every kid is ready for it. So if we come back around, the more repetitions that we get to that thing and at different points in the year, they might be more ready for it at different times. The downside of that was when I was teaching out of a spiral curriculum, it really felt like I was moving on before the kids were ready, which is kind of the point, but I could see them get defeated because they never felt like they had success. So some of those kids who just get it, like the first time, they always felt successful. And my students who didn't get it that first time felt defeated, and then we would be on to something new, and they didn't get that, and we'd be on to something new, and they didn't get that. It just felt like I was always bringing something to them, and they didn't get it. And by the time we bring it back around, they're already so defeated and it's partway through the year and they're hating math. So I personally did not like teaching out of a spiral curriculum. You may have a different viewpoint on that, but that was my viewpoint. A mastery curriculum is where the curriculum tends to focus on a certain content for a longer period of time, going in depth, letting kids approach that concept in lots of different ways. So if I'm teaching a, you know, two-digit addition, we would spend a lot of time focusing on two-digit addition, looking at it in different ways, looking at it in context, and really building mastery around that content before I moved into two-digit subtraction or before I moved into measurement concepts. So you're really focusing in depth on a concept, which I loved. The downside of that type of curriculum is that you don't bring it back around. So you're focusing on two-digit addition for, let's say, a month, maybe 2 months, depending upon how long you need to spend on it with your kids. And then you don't bring it back up again. And so by the end of the year, they may have forgotten the things that we talked about in the beginning of the year. So there's pluses and minuses to both types of curriculum. I want you to know which type of curriculum you have so that you know what's the issue. If you're teaching out of a spiral curriculum, it may not be that the kids don't understand, but it's just moving too fast and they don't feel like they're going in depth enough. If you're teaching out of mastery and you feel like, oh my goodness, we are almost, you know, towards the end of the school year and the kids seem to have forgotten stuff that we did at the beginning, that's because we haven't brought it back up. So be mindful of those issues and work towards doing things that help solve it. So if you're in a mastery-based curriculum, you can do things like doing review every single day. Have a little 5-minute review times that you can bring that back up. Or if you use guided math, having those things that you've done kind of in the beginning of the year could be in your stations and your work times so that they can get more review stuff. So be mindful, look for those things, and then know that you're going to have to supplement in different ways no matter what curriculum your district goes with. Now, if you want official documentation of what is a good curriculum and a not-so-good curriculum, there is a site called Ed Reports. Ed Reports has a very lengthy process. They go through evaluating curriculum series. So I want you to take a look at that, but take a look at the results there with a grain of salt. because there's only, I think, one Eureka Math that is all green across the side there. The link that I take you to gives you a little comparison chart. And Eureka, I think, is the only one that has all green. There's some that are pretty much all green, but have a little couple yellow spots in there. But Eureka, which is also known as Engage New York, you could ask 10 people and you will get probably 5 of them that love it and 5 of them that hate it. So again, even though the Ed reports might say this is a great curriculum, again, it goes back to your teaching style and your philosophy of how math should be taught to students. So there is no one great best curriculum out there. I want you to keep these two things in mind, the conceptual versus procedural, and whether it's a spiral versus a mastery curriculum. And you can go to Ed Reports to see their official documentation, but I also want to invite you into our Facebook group. We have over 20,000 teachers in there, and people post all the time asking questions, and you can get personal responses from teachers who are using that particular curriculum, and maybe they've been using it for a few years, and your district just adopted it, and you want to get some insight into what they feel are the good points and bad points of the curriculum, this is a great place. And it's not just about curriculum. There's definitely a lot of other things that people talk about inside of this group, but it is one of the biggest things I see people asking inside of that group. So keep those two things in mind and come on over and join the Build Math Minds Facebook group so that we can all build our math minds so we can help build the math minds of our students. Have a great day.